Welcome back. It's really quite impressive that the Lightning is now 500 because they have the league's fifth worst goal differential at minus 18. Yes, they have a mishmash of defensemen playing right now, but even to sniff a return of the playoffs, that trend has to turn around, and it started at home. Great honor at the beginning of the game for Lightning founder Phil Esposito. The team unveiled a bronze statue in his honor before the game with Carolina, and of course, plenty to celebrate inside. 2-on-1 there. That's a goalie nightmare. St. Louis to Stamkos hammers at home. Tied at one at the end of one. It was the start of an awesome night for Stammer in the second, weaves through traffic, and he's showing new ways to score in his game. Finds an opening. That was his second of the night. Begin the third on a power play, and this is Stammer's moneymaker. Pounds in the one-timer on the power play. Hat trick in his league-leading 26th of the season. Lightning would add two more. They win it 5-2 and sweep the three-game homestand.
I'll definitely take the hat trick. It was nice to get that, obviously, in a big game like this, and to play with Marty and Downs again, and just seemed like we had that instant chemistry like old times. So we got a lot of big games coming up, and we need wins.
Four lines on the three pairs and the goaltender, they all did their job, and it was a real team effort in all aspects of the game. So it was very solid.
We knew how important it was, and obviously you get three wins and get back to 500 and get yourself back in a chase. And take that game on the road, feeling good about yourself, and yeah, it was big.
The most analyzed move of the offseason for the Bucks was letting middle linebacker Barrett Rood leave in free agency. In his place, the team drafted Mason Foster in the third round out of Washington. Foster has started since the season opener and leads the team in tackles like Rood always did. But having a rookie middle linebacker has certainly led to some missed calls, but you can't put the poor tackling on Foster. Another positive sign, though, every week Foster takes questions from the media about what's going wrong. This team needs more young leaders like Foster to get out of this mess, and that's why the team liked him in the first place.
We made a collective agreement to go young when we took over this program. You know, when that's something we wanted to do. And in order to upgrade in certain positions, sometimes you got to get worse before you get better. And going out and getting a young middle linebacker is something that we decided to do, and we did it.
I learned something new each and every week, and I felt like I got better as the season progressed. But it's definitely been tough, you know, because you see how good of a team you can be, and to lose those games in a row like that is always tough.
So how has the Bucks draft class fared? Here are my grades. First-rounder Adrian Claiborne, give him a B+. He's got a team-leading 7.5 sacks and 3 forced fumbles. Daquan Bowers, definite A. He was an early projection for the top overall pick and has shown no signs of a lingering knee injury. Foster will give him a B-. It's tough to start in the middle as a rookie, but he handled it well. After that, it's not good. Ahmad Black and Anthony Gator get incompletes. They lived on the practice squad. Tight ends did not perform at all. Luke Stocker gets a D. Daniel Hardy and running back Alan Bradford were cut in training camp, so those picks get Fs. USF basketball sits at 7-7 heading into the new year. It's not really where Stan Heath wants his team, but several starters have missed multiple games due to injury. Now for the past three games, Heath has seen his full roster in action and sees a missing spark filled by the return of junior Jawan Zapoland.
It felt good to get up and jump.
And Jawan Zapoland will make you pay.
Jawan Zapoland has shown no side effects from the back injury that caused him to miss 9 games. After an additional 2-game suspension, his return has energized USF's offense.
You know, sometimes you need that player, you know, that player that things are breaking down, things aren't happening, that can just get a basket for you. Jawan Zapoland's a guy that can do that for us.
I feel real good coming back, running up and down, practicing hard in the games, you know, running up and down, going hard. So it feels real good to be back.
Poland's athleticism complements a solid post game for the Bulls. Maybe more important, freshman point guard Anthony Collins has a near 2-1 assist to turnover rate.
Then orchestrating our offense, 6 assists, no turnovers in your first Big East game. The best is still yet to come, but it's pretty good right now.
I think that it's more impressive for, you know, everybody watching. You know, we've been out here. We already knew what he can do. You know, I was ranting and raving about AC, you know, all summer.
The Bulls defense has done its part with the second fewest points allowed in the Big East. Heading into 2012, USF's offense needs to improve its conference worst scoring. A healthy roster feeds confidence of a turnaround.
We need to score off our defense. So, I mean, so we playing good defense. We just got to start getting some easy buckets and stuff like that.
You're seeing alley-oop dunks. You're seeing some nice highlight plays. So the chemistry is really coming together. The defense is coming together. We want to score more points. We're playing good. We need to play a little bit better.
And finally, Florida avoided the Ivy League upset that FSU suffered last night. Gators cruised past Yale. Kenny Boynton led the way with a game-high 26. And how good is Bradley Beal? Give him an early candidate for National Freshman of the Year. Check it out. Throwing down the one-handed jam. Florida wins it 90-70, and that's it. Have a happy new year, and we'll be back with more after this.